It wasn't about making money. Of course, money was a scorecard to build a business that was socially sustainable, okay? Whereby we were paying fair wages where at the same time the company was profitable. I could have slept in a box, I would have been happy. The success of the business is what brought me my joy. It's a nut show out there. It's scary. Like, LA is the best place to be if you're an entrepreneur. This is an entrepreneurial town. You could build a business, but you could fall pretty hard here in as a result of the employment laws. And people always say, oh, you got in trouble for this and you got in trouble for that. But you know what? The funny thing is, everybody I know in a position of power in this city has almost faced the same story. So it's either under the table or not everybody heard about it, and maybe it didn't hit the newspapers. What does it all mean to you? I don't know. Don't get scared. Get out there and fight and build your companies. Don't be overcome by fear, because I'm not. Because even though I lost everything, I got to get up every day and keep fighting for the next thing and to do something great, you know? We can't just relentlessly pursue low-cost wages. So I intend to prove all that out. I think I already did it with American Apparel, but now I got to do it again. And there was all this false information they put out in order to justify my ousting. Oh, the company was, well, it wasn't losing money. This company was generating profits pre-interest. That's the bottom line, pre-depreciation, which is non-cash. So I'm going to get out there and do it again. And I'm gonna, you have to be cautious out there sometimes. But don't lose that spark, that, you know, the spark of freedom is what makes stuff happen too, so you gotta balance it all. But we'll see where things go in society now, and we'll see how it all happens and unfolds. So that's a little bit about my journey, and I'm happy to answer any questions anyone may have.
Yes.